The IPO rush has turned into an IPO wreck for some of the big name companies that made their public debuts in the last year or so. Leslie Picker joins us now with more on that. Hey, Leslie.
Hey, Wolf. Good morning. Remember all those large day one pops for IPOs in the first half of the year? Well, most of those companies have already shaved off their debut gains thanks to some of the recent market volatility. Take a look at the real. That stock plummeting 23% on Friday on no real news. Just 6 weeks ago, when the online consignment retailer went public, 6 weeks ago, guys, the stock surged 45%. Now, those investors that bought in at the IPO and held it are in negative territory, down more than 11%. It's a similar story with Jumia. That's the African e-commerce retailer that jumped 76% in its April debut. But then last week, it too fell below issuance price. That stock is now trading 15% below its IPO. Fiverr also has lost most of its day one gains of 90%. Now the freelance marketplace is trading just 7% above its IPO price. Now the vast majority of IPOs have actually traded down from their day one performance. Nearly two-thirds have performed worse since their debuts, according to a CNBC analysis. But some have actually improved. Avedro traded down 12% on its debut, but thanks to last week's acquisition announcement by fellow ophthalmic drug maker Glaukos, Avedro is now 65% higher than its IPO, guys.
So are we saying this is good environment if WeWork rushes theirs out? And when do we expect WeWork?
I mean, it could be problematic for those companies that are coming out in September, because one of the big components of a successful IPO is how past IPO IPOs have performed, because that makes investors more inclined, if they've performed better, more inclined to buy in at higher valuations for the newer issuances that are coming down the pike. So if you are a WeWork or one of these companies that are looking to come in the near future, in the next couple weeks or so, this could be problematic for you, although it could also prevent things from getting worse as well.
And a lot of these IPOs from earlier this spring are going to be facing lockups pretty soon.
Exactly.
So that could be another potential sliding event.
Yeah, lockup expirations are supposed to start as soon as next week, the 19th, with Lyft's lockup expiration, in terms of the kind of bigger marquee deals that we were really covering. And CNBC found that that could unleash, I mean, as much as $215 billion, not everybody will sell into their, you know,
but
lockup expiration date.
But if you see performance like this, perhaps more employees than would otherwise.
How big is the calendar in September, you know, outside of, like, the big name like WeWork?
It's pretty significant. There have been reports showing that WME IMG will file in September. Other reports have shown Smile Direct Club. We reported that Smile Direct Club was aiming for a September debut for their IPO.
Got Postmates coming, right? Or is that going to be, you think that's more
sure
of an October?
Not sure if that will be September or not.
Where is Peloton?
Peloton could be September.
Okay.
Datadog is another one that I've heard about from sources that could be an interesting September debut. So it could be, I'm told it will be a busy September and not to take any vacation.
Leslie, thanks very much. Great to see you, Leslie Picker. Changing topic, final questions to Peter Boockvar. Peter, so you're skeptical that a Fed rate cut can really help, particularly if it's the trade war that it's trying to fix. Presumably you're very skeptical about anything that Christine Lagarde's going to be able to do when she takes up the helm at the ECB.
Well, Draghi has basically taken the next easing step for her with what he'll do in September and then pass it on to Lagarde.
Do you think he will actually change policy in September rather than change rhetoric?
I think he wants to, but the deterioration in European bank profitability and what's happening to these European bank stocks is really scary. They seem to go down every single day. They were down about 7% last week. So I wonder if that is a trigger for him not to. But here we are in a situation that if he doesn't follow through, we're going to see a big sell-off in European bonds. If Lagarde is successful in generating fiscal stimulus through jawboning the individual governments into spending, well, then that creates another problem for European bonds. Mm-hmm. So it's a difficult situation anywhere you look.
And in terms of what that means for the dollar, where do you stand at the moment?
Well, I think everyone looks at the dollar homogeneously. It's either going up or it's going down, but it's going up against some currencies, and it's really not doing anything against others. I mean, look how well the euro trades against the dollar, with all the issues that the Europeans have with negative interest rates and slow growth.